back leg, you're trying to tuck that, heel under so it's actively engaged. Front leg, my heel is pushing up away from the floor. Can you feel it? All right, now we're gonna switch through this. Switch sides, you're just gonna turn, pivot.
I'm gonna aim it like this, but I didn't.
No, you're okay. We were like this, and then I just pivot, and then we're gonna drop. You wanna be facing, I'm facing you so you can see me.
Okay,
so you wanna be facing the wall.
Okay.
Right, exactly. So
this one
if I did it with you, it'd be like this. And I'm gonna follow my hand, that's right. The front hand, that's your guide. Just looking over that.
Okay.
I'm gonna hold this. And then just lean back, bring that front hand up toward the ceiling, looking up. And then come back to your warrior. Hands come up, we're just going to switch, pivot sides. And hands come out. Looking over that, right now looking over our right hand. You're really bending into that front knee. You want to really lean into as much as you can, keeping your body straight. Minor adjustments. See if you can get your foot going all the way straight. You'll feel the difference here shortly. Front one is straight. One lower. And then horizontal. And then foot over. Then as you lean down, you want to still keep all that strength in your legs. Your legs right now are working, you feel it, right? Obviously, let's come back. We'll do one more. the series would start with Sunset Education. Oh, and also too, here's something. When we're doing these things, when we're coming down and I was out, you can use a block, okay? You could use your block right here like this. You can use your block right here like that. Like that. So the blocks really are our tools. And there's no shame, you know, in starting where you're at. I try to push myself, but I'll tell you, sometimes it's better to not push so hard, but to do it where you can maximize it. You know, I like to get it over with, but again, sometimes that does damage, so you have to go slow. So anyway, that's blocks you can
well,
use.
On the day next day, if you had a block, you were doing push-ups, to do one with one under and one other,
mm-hmm.
and it does something to your muscles. It gives it, it gives it a break or something. It just helps it.
There's so many different things you can do, but they're definitely handy. Just for people that, okay, not everybody starts out, I mean, it takes me months. You can't always go like this, right? But if you have a block, you know, it really just assists with every movement. People don't use them because they got pride, I got pride, but really, you know, they block. So, all right, here we go. We're going to start again. We're going to scoot down, arms up and out. And let's just lean forward. I'm just doing a different hand variation and none is wrong. Coming down slowly. Now I'm gonna take my hands, they're out to my side. I'm gonna reach them behind my back. Interlace them, interlace the fingers. And then see if you can't just really get into that to that stretch. Your arms are pulling, you keep there, I'm just gonna kind of give you a little pull. And you get extra attention though, because you're holding here, but I really, truly, it's nice when you can get it, because a lot of people don't. You feel that? A lot of times you don't get any touch or any kind of attention at all, so. All right, so we can bring your hands back to the floor. Go ahead, step that right leg back. We're gonna come right up into our warrior. This is a part, this is core yoga right here, warrior pose. Looking forward, your both feet are pointed in the same direction. I'm pointed toward the window, yours should be pointed toward the board here. All right, now we're gonna do something different because we're crazy like that. You watch me for a second. I'm gonna come forward, and I'm gonna bring that foot up. Now while you're here, again, this could be a block thing. I would take my block, put it in front of my foot, put my hand on that. Don't even worry about getting your other hand off the floor right now. Just get that leg, get that stretch. All right, we're gonna bring that foot back. We're still in an extended, would be side angle, but all right. From here, other foot's gonna go back into the top of the push-up. So we're gonna be right here at the plank. Body is straight, slowly come down. And push up. And back into the up dog. Now you can do this too. You can have your feet and actually lift your legs off the ground, or you can leave them on the ground and push back. Now from here, let's go ahead and just push back into our child's pose. Pushing going all the way back and relax for just a second. Deep breath. All right, come up onto your knees and your hands. We're going to switch. We're going to bring that left leg in front. We're going to come up, just pop that knee up. We just did that one, right?
We just did the
one. Yeah, we got to switch. Sorry.
Okay, so the right leg comes in front. I get myself confused. And then the left leg is going to come up off the ground. We're going to go right back, kind of doing it backwards without having to go up, back into our warrior. Lean forward. That's good. Keep your body, this part of your body is going to be straight. Now, remember what we did? We came forward and that leg came up. If you need your block, you can put your block again right in front. Really push that leg up as high as you can get it. I'm turning my body sideways a little bit to get that leg up a little bit further. You should be able to really feel a stretch in your leg that's planted on the floor. All right, lower that leg, the left leg onto the ground. Move that block out of your way if you used it. Front foot goes back into the plank position. We do a lot of push-ups, so you build your upper body here. Use your own weight. Down slowly. And push back and up. And toes under, we're going to go into a down dog. Remember that? You just push back. There you go. They call a down dog a resting position, but there's really a lot going on with it. Your stomach should be engaged. Your arms should be pushing away from the floor. Your heels are trying to come down to the floor. Can you feel it?
Because you're real long and I am queen. You're just a lot better shape than
I am. Oh, yeah, look, Pam, I'm in bad shape, but I've been doing this longer, so you're doing good, real good. I'm going to hold this stretch as long as I can, just a couple of seconds more, a couple breaths. You can watch. This will be one of our next poses, okay? So you can see this for the next time. Here's a pose we'll be doing right from this position. Do neck burn. Well, make sure you keep everything, if you're using it, let me stop for a second. Stop and take this. We're using them, but you still want them, especially your neck, to try to relax it, right? So let's just take a second. Do our turns. Go up and back. See, this will probably, you haven't done this, us even just doing this will put strain on your neck.
Well, mine was up here and then up here.
Okay.
It's quickness. I'm just twisting it.
This isn't a bad time to throw this in, so I'll accept it. While we're here, let's just go ahead and we'll transition into some floor. Now, again, you probably can do this, you might not be able to. So it's not about how big you are, it's how your muscles work, right? But it's easier if you put a blanket between your knees, between this part of your legs, and we're trying to just come back and relax right here, right? Now, I'm not, because I want to get a little deeper into it. And I'm going to try to go back, but it's been a while. So this is a good stretch. It stretches our knees, muscles all upon our upper legs. And if you lean forward and back, you can actually get a good back stretch too. Now, you come slow. Eventually have your elbows to the floor. What we're working for. Come back up. Don't stay here too long or hurt your knees, okay? If you're not used to it, you can kind of shake your knees out a little bit. We'll do it two more times. So and see if it does, if it helps.
I know. It doesn't help. It looks like I'm crazy. But when I was a kid, this is all the way I always sat.
Okay.
Even at the house, in the school desk, I always sat like this. I never sat with my legs down. I always sat. This does not bother me.
All right. Good.
But now when you try to make me lean back to the floor, I can't do it. But as far as this.
Go slow. Just go slow. Right here, even if just doing this, this is stretching all the way. All these muscles.
Pushing all this right through here.
Exactly. And don't forget to breathe. All right, let's slowly come up again. This is kind of a reverse of what we're doing, but I'm just gonna push back like a frog position. And there are poses, and you're right, like right there where you're at, you're almost ready for the crow. You'll be able to do the crow a lot faster than I can. And the crow is coming up onto your arms, which I'm not real good at right now. I don't have the balance I used to, but I can see that you're almost, you've got that, it seems instinctual. Yeah. Yeah, okay.
I can do all this stuff. I can do that now.
Oh, you're going to be able to, though. What? This is good stretch right here. So I'm just gonna hang right here. I'm gonna relax my head.
Now when you do the crawl, does your head touch the floor or does it?
Well, what I do when I do the crawl, not this block, but I have soft ones, I do it like this because I have a hard time. So I start out and just practice literally just like this. That's how I start out. And then eventually you do not want your head on the floor. You know, you'll be up, like they do it, some of these people are like all the way, they're up on their, you know, arms are all the way up and their legs wrap around. I would love to be able to, they do things where their feet, they're this way, their legs are sticking out that way. It's not going to be today for me though, right? All right, one more deep breath. And from here, let's come back, we got one more. One more time, we'll lean it back on our leg. Now again, each time you come back, if you do it three times, you've got muscle memory. So we're always trying to do something more than one time. All right, now I'm gonna try to come back as far as I can. Control your breathing. And let's slowly come back up. Alright, hands to the floor. Let's go ahead and push ourselves up and we're going to walk our hands forward. I'm just going to shake out right here. I'm going to shake my hands. Stretch my back. Grab my legs and pull in. And let's get ready on your next inhalation. Go ahead and swoop your hands and let's bring it up. And release. And it's a gorgeous day out. Look at those clouds, my goodness. All right. So we've got a few minutes left. So let's go ahead and do some balance poses. We started with the tree pose. That's a good balance one. Another thing you can do for balance, like even on the tree pose, even if you don't bring it all the way up, right, you're strengthening all your leg muscles, even if your foot is touching the floor, right? You don't have to bring it as high. But there's other things. Once you can get that balance, you can bring that knee up. Hold it up. There's a whole sequence. Oh, they used to hate me. Mm-hmm. I used to get this. But you can have a sequence of just balance. So you go from this balance, to that, to this, the foot goes out, and the foot goes back. So you have that whole time, that one leg is just there.
So it's here.
So you start out here. Let's see. And then
I went out or something. heavy here, and then I grab it underneath. Kick out. Bring it in and up.
That's where I lost it. That's where I lost it.
That. And you want to grab your toe and then out.
Oh my goodness.
And you want to grab it. Now again, woo, I'm getting, it's getting sore, right?
You're awesome.
Good as those. So. Now let's go ahead and switch sides though, because that side is not thank you very much. So again, you can do your tree here, you can come up, you can do it wherever. But you're done with tree.
I must be close to important.
No, did you see how bad the other side was me? One side is always difficult. I don't know what it is. More balance, obviously, when you let go of the wall, the balance comes in. It's a little color and more. What time is it in here?
It should be about 8 minutes till.
I don't know, I don't know that. We got 8 minutes to screw around.
Yeah.